dreamed a dream of Saint Francis, who kneeled and prayed for the birds and the beasts and all humankind. All through the night I felt drawn in by him, and I heard him call like a distant hymn. I retreated from the silence of my room, stepping down the ancient stones washed with dawn, and entered the basilica that bore his name.
Signor,
seeing his effigy, I bowed my head, and my racing heart I gave to him. I kneeled and prayed.
Dove c'è disperazione, speranza. Dove c'è oscurità.
And the sleep that I could not find in the night,
dove c'è tristezza, gioia,
I found through him.
Fa che non cerchi tanto di essere consolato.
I saw before me the world of his world. The bright fields. The birds in abundance. All of nature. Which he sang, singing of him. All the beauty that surrounded him as he walked. His nature that was nature itself. And I heard him speak. And the birds sang sweetly, and the wolves licked his feet. But I could not give myself to him. I felt another call from the basilica itself, the call of art, the call of man, and the beauty of the material drew me away, and I awoke and beheld upon the wall the dream of Constantine, the handiwork of Piera della Francesca, who had stood where I stood, with his brush stroked the legend of the true cross. And he envisioned Constantine advancing to greet the enemy. And as he was passing the river, an unaccustomed fear gripped his bowels, an anticipation so overwhelming that it manifested in waves. All through the night, a dream drew toward him as an advancing crusade. He slept in his tent on the battlefield while his men stood guard. And an angel awoke him. Constantine, within his dream, awoke. And his men saw a light pass over the face of the king, the troubled king. The angel came and showed to him the sign of the true cross in heaven. And upon it was written, "In this sign shall thou conquer." In the distance, the tents of his army were lit by moonlight, but another kind of radiance lit the face of Constantine. And in the morning light, the artist, seeing his work was done, saw it was good. In this sign shall thou conquer. He let his brush drop and passed into a sleep of his own. And he dreamed of Constantine carrying into battle in his right hand an immaculate, undefiled, and simple white cross. Piera della Francesca, as his brush stroked the wall, was filled with a torpor and fell into a dream of his own. From the geometry of his heart, he mapped it out. He saw the king rise, fitted with armor, set upon a white horse, an immaculate cross in his right hand. He advanced toward the enemy, and the symmetry, the perfection of his mathematics, caused the scattering of the enemy, agitated, broken. They fled, and Piera della Francesca, waking, cried out, "All is art, all is future. Oh Lord, let me die on the back of adventure, with a brush and an eye full of light." But as he advanced in age, the light was shorn from his eyes and blinded. He laid upon his bed on an October morning, 1492, whispered, "Lord, let me die on the back of adventure. Oh Lord, let me die on the back of adventure. Oh." And a world away, on three great ships. Adventure itself, as if to answer, pulling into the new world. And as far as his eyes could see, no longer blind, all of nature, unspoiled, beautiful, beautiful, in such a manner that would have lifted the heart of Saint Francis into the realm of universal love. Columbus set foot on the new world and witnessed beauty unspoiled, all the delights given by God, as if in Eden itself, as if Eden had opened up her heart to him and opened her dress and all of her fruit gave to him. And Columbus, so overwhelmed, fell into a sleep of his own. All the world in his sleep, all of the beauty, all of the beauty entwined with the future, the 21st century, advancing like the angel, advancing like the angel that had come to Constantine.